Hey, welcome back. And, you know, we need more from Frank.
Frank's going to tell us some more about the flip cam and really get into the software a little bit about how you can actually do the editing with the software that comes with the camera.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, this is the fun part. Once you shoot your video, you got your little clips on here like I showed you. There's a little window here. There's a little scissor window. You're just going to click on the scissor window, and another window is going to pop up. Now, this is really interesting because what you can do here is you can trim the beginning and the end, depending on what you need to do. So I'm going to click on here. This is my little handle, and I'm going to say, okay, I want that video to start about there, and I'm going to grab my end handle, and I'm going to say, nah, and I want it to end about there. So it's a basic edit. It's just the beginning and the end. There's no insert editing in here, and I like it. Now I have a choice, save as or replace. I'm not going to replace it because I don't want to ruin the original video, so I'm just going to do a save as. So that's going to come up, and it's going to ask me where to save it. I want to save it, and that it automatically goes to a file that it was in. So I have that, and I'm going to close that. Now I'm going to go to another clip. Same thing. Hit the scissors. I'm going to make a small edit here and there. I'm happy with it. Save as. Save. It's going to save as a copy. Now here's the magic. Now once I have my video clips edited, and I'm happy with the beginning and the end, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them together. So you go over here, there's a little here which says Create. I'm going to click on Movie. Now, it automatically placed in the first slot the clip that I had selected. So now all you're going to do is I'm going to get another clip. I'm going to grab it. I'm going to drag it over into this little area.
That easy?
And boom. Now I've got two. Now if you notice, the time frame here is 1:15. If you look at here, this is 54 seconds, that's 22. Well, guess what? Here's your movie. Here's your preview.
Cool.
Take a look. See if you like it first. If you don't
fast.
Like it, then you start all over again. But guess what? I like it. So I'm going to say next. I'm going to click next. Now it says, do I want a title? Yes, I want a title. I click title. I go over here in my little box, highlight it. I'm going to type the making of, or whatever you want to call it.
Nice. This is really easy to use.
And
speaking of
really
magic,
is,
I almost thought I saw somebody working in the control room in that one video clip. That would be magical.
That would be magical.
I know.
Now look, you see my preview? The little title's already up there. It says the making of CCC. Computers for the completely clueless.
Very good.
Okay. Next. Now it's saying, do you want to put music in it? Well, no, I'm not going to put music in this one, but you can. The flip video comes downloaded with some stock music already.
Awesome.
Now, I mean, come on, this is giving you all kinds of stuff here. Now you got
amazing
stock music here.
Is there a special format that you have to use?
MP3.
Okay, that's good.
And if you got music on your computer, you click on this little box and download your own music. And then here's some options for music. You want to play it softer, louder,
Frank, did you
or music
say,
only?
Is this Mac and PC?
Okay, that's a neat thing too. This is cross-platform software. If you plug it into a Mac, you're going to get the same thing. You plug it into a PC, you're going to get the same thing.
Awesome.
Wow, nice.
Somebody's thinking out there.
I like that.
So that was nice. So I did my little no music. I'm going to go next. It says, okay, where do you want to save your movie? That's what you want to call it in that folder. Yep, create movie. I click that. Down here, it's going to spend a little time. It's going to render that movie. Now, this may take a little while.
Yeah,
I may not have the time
can be
to show you.
Thing.
But my next step would be to either share it, email, a greeting card, well, or online. So if I was making a video lesson for my classroom or a little instructional video, I would go to online and I would download it to Vodcast. Boom, there's my video. It's up and done.
That's
I did it all
nice
by myself.
Now, so this is
no
what used to
software
be a $600 or $700 camera that you had to carry on with a case and a bunch of cables and a battery charger, and now it's been shrunk down to this size and comes with the editing software. This must be like $2,000.
Okay, how about $199? And it's even cheaper if in the school district. Go to GovConnection.
I bought one for
one of our vendors.
I bought one for $80 on Whoop.
Right.
Yeah.
I saw that and I missed it.
Yeah.
And again, this is not the only model. This is not the only manufacturer out there. I know a lot of people speak highly of the Kodak version of this.
Yeah. Yes,
and
Kodak
some other
has
ones
one
as well.
The new Nano came out with a recording, recording on it.
Nano,
so they're all seeing the value of having something portable with you
that
to get
you
the video
the
to download.
Time. Because that's always been the problem with video camera. You have to carry a case with all that extra paraphernalia.
And one of the pluses of this is it has the software on it, too.
It comes
like
with it.
It.
That's and again, big. Cross-platform. One other thing real quick.
Okay.
If you want to know more about it, you go to flipshare.com. Complete site has support, video, information, tips, and everything like that. And there it is. Flip and focus.
Very That's cool, great. Frank.
Okay.
Very cool. All right. Thanks, Frank. We really enjoy having you on here because Frank's the video guy.
Yeah, and
we're going to change directions a little bit. But that is what a cool thing to be able to do, all your editing and filming. And I love I carry mine around my backpack now. And so if I get in a position where I'm free to shoot some video or stuff, I've got my camera right with me.
Very easy, very quick. Just take it out.
Very cool.
So what are we going to talk about?
You and I are going to do an online mapping service shootout today.
Okay.
And we're going to talk about the three big services. Well, actually, there's four big services, but there's three cool ones. And there's one old one or older one.
I know what you're talking about there.
And we're talking about Google Maps, Yahoo Maps, Microsoft Maps, which is now called Bing Maps.
Yes.
Next week it might be called something else because Microsoft likes to change names a lot.
It's good for 2 years.
Okay, good for 2 years. And then we'll talk a little bit about MapQuest, which is the original map service. And some people still use that as a verb. You know, I want to MapQuest the directions to something. But there, MapQuest is not the only one out there.
No,
we're going to actually, I want to dip into Yahoo Maps here for just a second. And then we'll come back on in the next segment and go into this a little bit further. So in most cases, maps.yahoo.com is the place that you want to go for this particular service. And what's really fascinating about Yahoo Maps isn't really the service itself necessarily, but the fact that it has a great developers network. So I'm on Yahoo Maps now, and let's say I wanted to do a search. I'm going to get driving directions from the area where we are now to a spot in New York, and I'm just going to plug in zip codes to do that, and I'm going to tell it to go.
So you don't need a whole address.
You don't even need a whole address. I just want to kind of get an idea. Say, for instance, I'm going to make a trip to New York, and I want to kind of figure out how long it would take me.
And that's pretty much true on all the sites.
It is true on all the sites. You can just use by zip codes, and you get a turn-by-turn, and they're all kind of similar. You'll have turn-by-turn directions. It'll tell you how long it is, the estimated time it'll take you to get there if you obey the speed limit, and so forth. Now, a lot of the more advanced ones now allow you to alter your route.
Good cue there.
Right. So let's say, for instance, that I've got this map, but I want to go and I want to visit somebody in, let's take Jeff and we'll go to Augusta. Who's that guy?
Okay.
Who's that guy who likes to golf? Yeah, we'll swing by Augusta on the way up, we'll take a look at that. And you can just adjust on the fly your route. Notice that it changes it, tells you the time it's going to take you to make that alternate route, and I can even go back to my original route.
I didn't know you could do that on the
Yahoo
version.
You can on Yahoo Maps. And I know the thing that you like, Lee, is the traffic. And when we come back, we'll look at traffic, but I also want to show you the developers that are using Yahoo Maps to do some
great. That's a really nice thing. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on Palm Breeze Cafe.